गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन लैब क्लास। आज दिस वन इज योर फर्स्ट क्लास वेयर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज योर बेसिक कंप्यूटर ऑपरेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक। व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर? द कंप्यूटर वर्ड comes from the Greek word compute. It is an electronics device which convert raw data into meaningful information with the help of stored instruction. In other terms, it can be called as device which takes input and gives us output under the control of set of instructions called a program. Next is identification of different components of computer. So the first one is keyboard. As you know, keyboard is one type of input device. So it is an input device and it allows the user to interact with the computer directly, and we are able to type the text from keyboard. So keyboard reassembled an electronic typewriter. As keyboard has some special function key, for example F1, F2, F3, like such a manner, F12 is the last function key. Next, on your keyboard, the escape key is there, caps lock key is there, tab key, shift key, alter key, control key, and we are frequently using the enter key also. Next input device is your mouse. It is an input device which used to point and select on the video or monitor. As this mouse is used for graphical purpose and it is having maximum of 3 buttons, and the function of each button is determined by the program that uses the mouse. A mouse can be classified as optical or mechanical, depends upon the basic technology. Then monitor. The most commonly used output device is VDU, video, your video display unit, or it can be also pronounced as visual display unit also. Okay, it is used to display information on the screen. The information modes are text mode or graphical mode. Then the CPU part is there. The CPU means central processing unit. It is the brain of computer where all data should manipulate with specified instruction, then it display the output. It also control the input, output and storage device. And as you know, the CPU section is divided into 3 basic parts, like memory unit, control unit and arithmetic and logic unit. So what is that memory unit? It is called the main storage unit where we can store the data temporarily or permanently. And CU is your control unit. It is the central nervous system of computer which control, maintain order or direct the operation of the entire system. It also control the input output devices, means your keyboard and your input device. As you know, keyboard your input device, mouse is your input device, and video printer is under your output devices. Then last one is your ALU. It performs the arithmetical calculation and logical decision. It also manipulates the data like addition, multiplication, subtraction and division. So here you got the idea about input device, output device and your CPU section. and the CPU section is nothing but it is having the memory unit, control unit and ALU unit. Now we are going to start about the step to switch on the computer. So what is the procedure, what is the step, how you are switch on your computer. So first of all, you have to make it on your switches from your switchboard. Then you have to switch on the UPS, and next you have to on the CPU. Then you have to make it on your monitor switch. Then after some moment, it will start the system with the Windows operating system or any other operating system. Okay. Next, what is the step to shut down the computer? The shortcut key is nothing but Alt plus F4 key is the shortcut key to shut down your computer. And if you are having Windows 7 or Windows 10 operating system, you have to click on your Windows key option, means your start option, where you will be find out the shutdown option or power option is there. Click in power option, select on shutdown, your system is getting shut down. Okay. Otherwise, in case of Windows 8, your mouse pointer to be moved extreme right corner of your screen, that is just above of the taskbar. Click on setting, click on power, then click on shutdown. Okay. And next is your the booting process. Booting means what? To start the system. So the process to activate the machine from dead stage to active stage is called booting. It is having two types. One is your cold boot and another one is your warm boot. Cold boot is nothing but your normal booting. Whenever you are starting your system first time, that is called your cold boot. Means after shutdown, when you start your system, that is called cold boot. And warm boot is nothing but whenever you are starting your system forcibly, that is called warm boot. So as a shortcut, we are pressing Ctrl, Alt and Del key. Now next topic is your layout of front panel and back panel of computer. So here the system front panel is display. Now as you know, this is the power switch key. When you press this power switch key, automatically your system is getting started, and some of your system is having this reset button also to restart your system. And these are the two jacks are there, that is for headphone, and mic port is there, and some USB ports are there. Okay. And here the common things, CD or DVD drive is there, and in old system some floppy drive format is also available here. On this slot the floppy drive option is there. Okay. Now next is your go for back panel of computer. So as per back panel of computer, this is the total layout of back panel of computer. Okay. Now see, this total option is nothing but called your power supply unit or SMPS. So where the power connector is there. Okay. So this 3-pin is nothing but your power connector. And this power supply fan is there. So this one is called power supply cooling fan. Okay. Power supply cooling fan. Next is your for keyboard and mouse. This point, this port is nothing but called PS2 port. Okay. This round circle port is called your PS2 port. The PS2 keyboard should be connect here, and PS2 mouse connector should be connect here. Okay. Next is your serial port. This serial port is also used for connecting mouse also. Okay. Next, this one is your parallel port. This is for your printer connection. And next is this blue one is called VGA port. So your monitor is attached here. Next, your USB port. As already on your front panel, the USB ports are there. On your back panel also, that same USB ports are there. Okay. Next, here that same thing for microphone jack, audio out jack, and line jack. These are the ports are there. Okay. Now, this is the case cooling fan. Just like your exhaust fan for the cooling of your system, here the case cooling fan is there. Okay. Next is your this port. This port is nothing but called your RJ45 connector port, or it can be pronounced as Ethernet LAN port also. Okay. And same thing here also, RJ11 modem port is there. Okay. This one is RJ45 LAN port, and this one is your RJ11 modem. And these are the expansion slots. This one. This expansion slot is used for attaching some new graphics card or Wi-Fi LAN card. Okay. So here you got the idea about the basic things, basic components, and your layout of front panel and back panel of system. Thank you, students.